we're not using PDFs as ways of communicating the information, then we're doing it wrong.
PDF oftentimes gets a bad rap as not being BIM or not being a part of that process. How is the technology actually enabling some of that very informative, collaborative information? How are you seeing that?
My perspective of the PDF, because if you think about it, I'm a database guy, right? What would I have to do with PDFs? But I think there was a question that was asked that I thought was a perfect question. If we have these PDFs, how do they have proposed value with the database idea? And ultimately, PDFs are a way of communicating a certain point in time. This is what we have right now that I need you to communicate with me on. It's much easier to communicate within that context versus spinning a massive healthcare project around in a 3D environment. The whole purpose of creating drawings is to illustrate a specific question or to answer a specific question. So if we're not using PDFs as ways of communicating the information, then we're doing it wrong. The worst PDF that I can ever see is a door schedule that's on a 60-inch piece of paper. Because if you're actually spanning a giant piece of paper PDF without really knowing what's in that grid of numbers, that's probably not the best way to communicate. But a quarter-inch detail of how that vapor barrier is interacting with that stone condition, that drawing becomes critical. That will never be driven in a database. Never drawn in a model. If you're modeling vapor barrier, you're doing that wrong too.
Absolutely.
So I think the drawings are the classic, you know, way of illustrating a specific question and getting that feedback. And the feedback loop is what's really important. That whole loop process, give me your comments so that I can integrate them in my model, integrate them into my database. That's really, to me, the key value of where the purpose of a really clear way of communicating a drawing and getting that feedback loop is important.
I think people tend to get caught in a utopian idea of anything. And you will get people, I mean, you probably find it all the time, that people are going, PDF? We don't want that. We want model data. We want to be looking at it in 3D. We need 3D coordination. We need data in the model. Well, actually, we've got to kind of get back to a little bit of practicality in this world and actually realize that, yes, okay, the model is really important. The data in the model or out of the model is really important. What is important is the big picture. And it's not just the right information at the right time, but in the right format to somebody to be able to interpret it.
Yeah.
And let's face it, 90% of the outputs on the modeling side is still drawing. You know, yes, there are specifications and schedules and things like that, but actually it's still the drawing that is the main form of communication. What is important, though, is that data is coming from a validated and verified set of information.
That's right.
It's a rendition of that information, just like an IFC is a rendition, or a 3D PDF is a rendition. It's a rendition of exactly something in time communicated for a specific purpose. And what we've got to do is get people where they're comfortable with that notion so that the tech heads, you know, the BIM nerds of this world aren't sitting there going, well, that's not really UK BIM level 2, is it? Yes, it is. And actually, you know, as we've had the conversation, it states in PAS 1192 part 2 that PDF is a deliverable from the project. But it's the single source of truth that's important.
Yeah. I'm a BIM guy. Mm-hmm. How in the world do you do BIM without 2D? How do you do it without the most current set of PDFs that are available to you? How do you run coordination? Yes, I have a model. I love my model. I trust my models. But I can't do BIM without a PDF. I've got to have my plans. When I run a coordination meeting, I talk to you guys about this. I run my coordination meeting with my plans because it has information that's critical for me to be able to run my coordination meeting that is not in the model. Mm-hmm. You can't honestly run a coordination meeting without having the 2D documentation up there. So we're constantly going back and forth and communicating what we see on the plans. I look at PDF as another tool that supplements this process. The rate that we have to keep up with changes in projects is faster than ever. They're expecting so much in such a short period of time, and that common language for us is the PDF. It's a stage in the life, as you say, of what we're doing with BIM.